The blood circulation, the animal have a true circulatory system. It is mostly closed and have a colorless blood that moves nutrients and waste material from one part of the to another part. And there are two vessels present on the dorsal and ventral surface of the animal. The heart is the anterior, present in the dorsal vessel, and though both vessels are contractile in nature, right? So heart is basically the part of the blood vessel, not the separate organ. And that part is a little bit swollen and more stronger, muscular in nature, and this pumps the blood from one point to the whole body. The blood moves from posterior side to the anterior side. So here you see the animal. This animal has the proboscis here, so this is the anterior side. And so in the dorsal blood vessel, the blood moves from the anal region towards the heart or towards the proboscis region. And from the heart, it goes to the only excretory organ, that is glomerulus, a wheel organ, that filters up all the waste, and then it pumps the blood back into this ventral artery or ventral blood vessels, which takes the blood in the backward direction. And this way, that loop is completed at the end of the body. These two dorsal and ventral vessels are basically connected with each other by this branching network of the arteries in the pharyngeal region. And this there is a reason having these branches in the pharyngeal region is as the water passes through this pharyngeal region, all the oxygen is diffused into the blood, and CO2 or other waste gases are diffused out into this water, and water cleans the blood of the animal.